Badami, the medieval capital of the Chalukyas, lies in a red sandstone ravine. On its southern side are four rock-cut caves of the 6th century. Cave 1, a Shaiva temple, transports us to the 1st millennium 550 CE. An external veranda with carved columns is a feature of all the caves. On the right is Shiva as Nataraj performing the Tandav Nritya. His 16 arms depict phases of the cosmic dance. Inside the veranda is an androgynous Ardhanarishwar, Shiva fused with Parvati. Carved pillars separate the main hall, another common feature of the caves. The Chalukyas cut rock like titans but finished it like jewelers. Inside the mantap sits Nandi facing the inner sanctum. The central roof panel depicts a projecting Nagraj. On the other side of the veranda or Mukh Mantap stands Harihara. The right half as Shiva and Vishnu on the left. A trident-wielding Dwarpal stands over a fused bull elephant below. 64 steps carved into the rock lead up to Cave 2. A panel of Ganas holds up the platform as in the other Badami caves. The Dwarpals here hold flowers, not weapons. This panel depicts Vishnu in his fifth avatar as Vamana, the dwarf, holding an umbrella and transforming into Trivikrama. Look up to see the Matsya Chakra, a wheel with 16 fish spokes and a lotus hub. Vishnu in his Dwarha avatar rescues the earth goddess. Cave 3, the largest, lies 60 steps up the rock face. This is the only Badami temple dated precisely to the 1st of November 578 CE. It is a fusion of the northern Nagara style with the Deccan style. Giant figures of Trivikrama with his foot on Mahabali's head, Narsimha, and a beautiful Harihara are carved on the wall panels. In the mantap lies a lotus. Above is Brahma surrounded by Yama, Varun, Indra, Kartike, and Vidyadhara couples. At the eastern wall, a magnificent Mahavishnu holds Darbha while seated on Shesha. His vehicle Garuda and consort Lakshmi are on either side. Astabhuja, eight-armed Vishnu, stands outside at the entrance. Cave 4, a Jain temple lies further east. On the right wall a lifelike Parasivnath meditates with a five-headed Naga protecting him. Jain Tirthankaras adorn the wall on either side of the Garbhagriha. Mahavir, the 24th Tirthankara, is seated on a lion. Jakav, a Jain nun, sits beside him on a wall panel. On the far wall winds entwined Bahubali as he meditates standing for 11 years. Cave 4 gives an aerial view of Agastya Tirtha and the 7th century Bhutanath temple. Badami fort emerges from the ravines opposite the caves. It was completed in 544 CE by the Chalukya king Pulkesan I. Most of it is in ruins and was plundered after a defeat by the Pallavas in 642 CE. The two multi-storied freestanding mantaps were probably ceremonial complexes. Strategically placed watchtowers overlook Badami Old Town. Tipu Sultan occupied the fort until it was taken by the Marathas in June 1786. The granaries were built by him. The upper Shivalik constructed in the 7th century is crowned by a large kuta without a finial, the earliest example of this Dravida roof style. The square tower over the sanctuary has pilastered walls. The central pilastered projection on the north wall shows Narsimha disemboweling Hiranyaksha. These support miniature eaves and beautiful kudus. The kudus intrude on the kapota eaves. 1,500 years ago, Pulkesin I bathed in the glow of a Badami sunset. Today it was ours to enjoy.